Good morning, everybody. Thank you for being here. We have a really amazing mix of people in the room today, from farmers and ranchers. We've got grassroots nonprofits. We've got scientists. We've got healthcare professionals. We've got doctors. If we can't get something done with this group, I apologize in advance.
We're about 20 miles outside of Boulder, Colorado, with some of the most amazing people on the planet. We're making a stand that we don't want a food supply that makes us sick.
There are so many people that I come in contact with who really are in such denial about this until it directly affects them.
We've created an entire economic system based on sick care, and people are now realizing that the existing structures are not working.
A health crisis is an agriculture crisis. It's directly related to farming. Our addiction to convenience is killing us. We need a total paradigm shift.
People really underestimate the power of food and its impact on our health. Food is medicine. When diet is wrong, medicine is of no use. When diet is correct, medicine is of no need.
The food is medicine movement is spreading throughout the country, but something is very much missing from the movement, and that is the attention to where the food is sourced. The food is medicine world talks a lot about equity for people who are low income, who face a lot of chronic disease, but why would we give those people the worst food available? There's no equity in that.
There is a lack of awareness about the nutritional quality of our food system.
Blueberries can be a great source of antioxidants. Our lowest quality blueberry samples that were sent in had less antioxidants than a wheat sample.
We hear a lot about this hidden hunger in the United States and abroad, and that's the idea is that we get plenty of calories, but we're not getting the nutrition that we think we're getting. So much comes back to just how the food is grown.
That's why I'm trying to bridge regenerative agriculture with the food as medicine movement. I think food as medicine has the ability and the dollars behind it to support and stimulate a whole new market for regenerative agriculture, one that values quality over quantity.
All of this area was all horse pasture, and it was deeply compacted soil. There was pretty much no life left in it. Just being able to see how these regenerative practices are actually remediating the land and the entire ecosystem at large is pretty incredible.
It was about 20 years ago when I found out that soil is alive. That was a bit of an epiphany.
People say, well, the regenerative farming model takes more labor, okay? So we're creating more jobs. What's not to like about that?
A big piece of this is really looking at land management, ecosystem management as a service.
As humans, we think that our job is to micromanage everything, right? No, we need to step back as farmers.
How do we improve our soil health? How do we document that this soil health creates healthier food? How do we know that that healthier food makes us healthier human beings? There's a lot to figure out.
We cannot heal from the soil in which we got sick.
We as farmers have to heal with the land. And until we do, there's no such thing as a healthy farm. There's no such thing as a healthy farmer.
How do we bring the idea of food as medicine to communities all across the United States?
The healthcare industry needs to be incentivized based on outcomes, and we need to help educate them on how to get there.
I want to see a check go back to the farmer because he helped somebody cure their diabetes.
It's an answer to so many problems. It's an answer to this idea of like, how are we gonna feed the population? Man, if we actually feed them something that has a high nutritional content, we don't have to grow more food.
We may be doctors, we may be farmers, we may just be mothers. But all of us have to be activists.